Well, hello everybody, it's Shug Shag, Shugity Shag Shag here. I've been a little bit absent lately. For that I apologize. It's been shoulder season here in Minnesota, meaning the trails up where I want to go in the North Shore are just muddy and boggy. Probably, let's see, today being May the 6th, there is still snow a little bit on the northern parts, way back in the woods. It's muddy, there's a little bit of ice left. They're not recommending us walking on the trails right now, and it's kind of a weird time of the year to go. So I immersed myself in a project. Yes, a control line airplane. Did I videotape it? No. You know why? Because I'm not a very good builder or finisher, and that was the point of my whole mission, was to teach myself how to do it. And I'm really proud of this thing. I flew it today for the first time, just a 2-minute test flight, nothing fancy, trimming it out. But let me show you this. It's called the Tutor 2. And when I do something, I do it all the way. I mean, I got limited time, so I've got about 175 hours in this thing. Yeah, that's the great thing when you're old. You have that kind of time. Now this aeroplane right here, I did a dope finish. It's silk span, it's painted, it's sanded. I did ink lines, and if you look at some of that detail in there, you can see these little black panel lines and dots. I did all that with a rapidograph pen. I still gotta buff this thing out. I even made a little pilot. That is me. If you can see that right there, that's me in there flying it. Even has my name right there, Sean Emery. I'm thrilled with the scheme. Building it was hard. Painting it takes hours and hours. You do a lot of sanding, sanding, sanding. Spray the primer on, sand it off. Primer on, sand it off. Primer on, sand it off. Filling the wood grain, filling the wood grain. Then you start spraying on your color. They call it dope. It's an airplane paint. It's always just been called dope. Hey man, way before dope was even dope. You know what I mean? Like dope, yo, dope, and dope, dope, and dope, dope, and like a dope. I'm really quite proud of it. All painted. The letters are masked and painted on. Anyway, it's called a Tutor 2. I'm going to be hitting the woods pretty soon. I just need a little break from hammocks. Sometimes you do all you can with hammocks, but there's only so much to do with a hammock. And I got sick of reviewing stuff. Reviews just get tiresome sometimes. They put a lot of pressure on. I got no interest in it right now. All I want to do is go out and play, 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 and do yard work. So we'll see you soon. Woo, buddy! Oh, get ready to feel that power. How about that? So that, my friends, is what I've been up to. That is where I've been, besides just doing chores and clearing out. I mean, I've spent days working in the backyard and getting rid of stuff. 6 van loads to the dump. Getting my camping stuff together, practicing. Life has been busy. This took some time, but I didn't have much time to do it because summer's gonna be busy, but it's done now. Now I'm just gonna show you some close up to this plane. And for those of you that watch for the camping, I'll be out there soon because I'm just dying to get out and camp. I just want to go out and enjoy my hammock and not have to answer any comments or even look at them. It's just where I've been lately. I just been wanting to back off from the computer and spend some late nights out here in my nut hut, burning the midnight oil till 3:30 in the morning, still getting up at 7 o'clock, not getting enough sleep. Yes, crawling in the hammock for the afternoon, maybe taking a half hour nap, and that has been beautiful. But that's where the old Shug is at right now. Woo, buddy, all secure in Sector 7. Hope you are too. So this is pretty cool. This is a flashback to my past. I was huge as a kid into this Major Matt Mason. This is Major Matt Mason. That's Chuck Mason, I named him, Sergeant Andrew Storm. Here's the space station. I'm gonna clean it all up and put it back together. hours of fun doing this. Hickory had them too, and unfortunately we burned all his. But mine survived. There's Major. No, that's Chuck Mason right there, as I named him. Sergeant Andrew Storm. And this is what was cool about this, is it's got this door. You close the door, and it would hook behind the space crawler. And one of the other things, and it rolls along the ground. Didn't have to wear his helmet when he was in there. Here's Major Matt Mason, the original, riding his space crawler. I gotta see if I can get this to work, but it had a winch right here. You could turn this winch on. It would go forward and backward, and it run some string out of here that would go back that way. And with these hooks on the space station, it would hook on the top. And I don't have the space station together. I want to clean everything up. And all the hook and the winch would go around the top and lift up and down. Here's the command module in here. A little telephone inside. There's the moon. Here's this little deal. It used to have these little rubber arms. They rotted off, and it had a bulb with these little you could pump the bulb in the arms and go burr, 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 and put him in there, and he could hook up inside. Major Matt goes inside that thing. Actually, let's put him in there. I'll show you. So he would go inside like that and could float off, and that's why those little rubber arms were his arms when he was in there. And had this light on top. Had a D-cell battery that would go in, and if you turned it this way, it would light up the inside like that. And you turn it up this way, and it would blink. Blip, 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 blip. And these are the orange legs for the space station that holds it up in the air. Here's one of his little flying machines. He would lay on there. And I don't know if I'm going to rework it, but it had string that ran through it. And if you pulled the string, you hooked it up to a doorknob, and something would fly across your room. Same thing as his jetpacks here. He had these jetpacks that would go on his back, and they had the string that runs through it, and if you pulled one end, you could actually hook these onto his space sleds, and the string would run through there, and you could hook it up to a doorknob, back up and pull it, and then he would fly across the room like that, and that little antenna on the top would turn as he looks through his red lens. I might take it apart and see if I can get it going again. So that's what I got there. Major Matt Mason. That might explain a lot about me, but that formed a lot of my childhood right there. Because, you know, I was always a little bit of a loner, and I could just play with that alone. It wasn't something that you really wanted to play with someone else. Hicks had his own game. I had my own game. We didn't play with our Major Matt Masons together. He had his game. I had mine. And his got burned in a horrible, horrible space accident. Called a pack of matches and me going, hey man, let's burn this stuff. We were sixth graders. Did we know any better? No, but his mom never let me forget it. Never, ever. Oh, look at that. All my underquilts and sleeping bags and top quilts just hang up there, ready to go. And there's Franken quilt right there with my Dutch chameleon and my Jack's or Better High Sierra Sniveler. Which is pretty cool because it can be worn as a serape. A serape? You say, what do you mean by this, Shug? Now, I didn't ask for it. It came in the mail, unbeknownst to me, but this is a Jack's or Better Sierra Sniveler. It's a top quilt. And it can also be used as an underquilt. But this is the cool thing about this one. So you undo everything so you can spread it out. And right in the center, it's got a piece of Velcro. Here's what's cool about this. So if you're a person that wants to go out camping and you're very concerned about, you know, weight, and you don't even want to bring a jacket with you, and you know, and a lot of times you get cold at camp and you're thinking, Man, I got a perfectly good top quilt over there, just laying in my hammock. You got a little clip, and here's a little loop, and you hook it like that. And here's what's cool about that, my friends, is I can wear this thing around. If you're really careful around a fire or don't have one, man, let's dork it out to the max. Okay, now I add a hood to this thing, and man, we are starting to look cool in the woods. Now, let's put on the jacks or better down sleeves and complete this ensemble. Okay, now I got my sleeves on. Now I'm gonna take this thing I was gone for a minute there. Now you put this serape back on, and you're the Incredible Hulk, man. You wanna mess with me? You wanna dance with me? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, rock, rock. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, rock, rock. We got something peculiar, something familiar, something for everyone. A comedy tonight. Woo, buddy, all secured Sector 7. Yes, sir. Whoop, pow.
I do have to say I'm sweating profusely after all that activity and all this down.